Jedi, you're about to witness it. After weeks of work, finally, an end to the darkness. These people, these marvelous, marvelous specimens, have been tested, no, purified, in the crucible of Tatooine's harsh environs. They alone are the hope of the galaxy. Their strength, their society, is the blueprint of our salvation.
What do you mean, blueprint?
They are simple, but long after the Empire and the Republic are gone, these people will remain. Their culture is built around strength. They cut the weak away like a societal cancer. Don't you see? It's the only way.
The Jedi Order has a responsibility to weak and strong alike.
How can I make you understand? They are the ultimate warriors purified by hardship. We must follow their example and cut away everything that would make us weak in the face of our adversaries, the frail, the diseased.
You're not thinking straight now. Look, I'm sick, Eris. You gonna cast me out too?
I have no choice. We must fortify the Republic with its strongest members and send this army of light out against the darkness.
An army of light that neglects the weak is no longer light.
You fools! To oppose me is to reveal your own weakness. You will be cast out. No, wait. Before you strike the killing blow, listen to me. I hear Lord Vivica's voice. I've failed him, just as I failed my old friend Porcanus when he died.
Why does everyone mention Porcanus?
I don't know, but I keep thinking about our first mission. Our ill-fated mission to Malachor III. We were all weak. We all came under the thrall of the dark side. We did things we regretted, but Porcanus was our strength. As we tried to escape, I fell behind, and he ran back to save me. He became trapped. We had to leave him. It was my weakness that killed him.
Porcanus knew the risk he was taking.
Yet I can't shake the feeling that his spirit hates me for it. It is why I have thrown myself into this project. Think about it. The Jedi Order spends so much time protecting the helpless and caring for the sick when we could be fighting the Empire. You must kill me. I was weak on Malachor III, and I'm weak now. But you must take my findings before the Council. Promise me that.
Let's see how you feel once Lord Vivekar no longer has a hold on you.
What? What was that? He's gone. Somehow you've driven Lord Vivekar away. I no longer hear his voice. I almost wish you hadn't done that.
Of all the ungrateful impudent, this Jedi saved your life.
Lord Vivekar twisted my mind, and I'm glad to be free of him. Still, my discovery remains. From these sand people, I have learned the key to building the unstoppable army. I feel I must bring these findings to the Republic. Yet, I can't shake this feeling that some truths are best left buried in the sand.
Using this information would mean the sacrifice of every good the Republic stands for.
You're right. These records are no more. Thank you for your guidance, and for saving me from Vivekar's grasp.
Well, Jedi, I'm glad Master Ares is alive and his own self. Best get back to Anchorhead myself. Sandrot's acting up and, well, frankly, sort of miss Darth Nurse's hollering.
Watch yourself while I'm gone.
Yeah, I've gotten by okay this far. Good luck with whatever it is you're doing, Jedi. Hope you find this Lord Vivekar.
Yeah. Located. Moving to intercept. Who needs targeting computers?
Show. Those enemy ships are nasty and quick. Watch out.
Take it down.
Jedi.
Down. General, I'm on Alderaan. Have you heard from Master Orgus?
Negative. Considering the chaos there, it's a wonder any messages get through. Alderaan's a war zone. The nobles are fighting to decide who's in charge, and whether this world aligns with the Republic or the Empire.
I thought Alderaan was already a Republic world.
When we signed the Treaty of Coruscant, hardliners on Alderaan formally withdrew from the Republic. Unfortunately, some nobles took the opportunity to ally with the Empire. My people developed a Deathmark weapon to end this conflict with surgical precision.
Extraordinary device. It marks targets with a microscopic tag. Undetectable. Tracks targets anywhere on the planet. Feed the target's coordinates to a focused beam laser, and it can kill them from across a continent.
Since when is the Republic in the assassination business?
If I can save a billion lives by killing one man, I'll gladly pull the trigger.
The Deathmark has one regrettable disadvantage. The targeting device's range is extremely limited, 20 meters or so. Once a target is marked, however, the laser can hit it from any range.
I fear efforts to guard the weapon have failed. Master Orgus's last transmission came from Organa Palace. After that, nothing.
Considering what happened to Master Kiwiiks, it's a sure bet Orgus is in danger.
Count Alder was the last to see Master Orgus. He co-funds the Deathmark project with us. I tried informing the Count of your arrival, but communications there have been crippled.
Reports indicate multiple holo relays destroyed. Standard Imperial battle tactic.
House Organa can't spare the troops to get their holo relays online. Maybe you can help?
I'll restore communications and then meet Count Alda.
Transmitting holo relay coordinates. If you get them up and running, it'll tighten House Organa's defenses. You'll find Count Alda at the embassy near Organa Palace. Good luck. Marsuthra out.